So welcome to St. John the Apostle. And before the Mass, I want to invite anybody who want to view the body. This is your last chance to do so before the Mass. So if you want, you can simply come up, you know, view the body of Emma. And then we will, in a few minutes, we will start the Mass. So at that time, the casket will be closed, and then the body will be in the middle during the Holy Mass. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today we gather together to pray for the soul of Emma. We also pray for the comfort of her loved ones. Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Emma, whom you have called to journey to you. And since she hoped and believed in you, grant that she may be led to our true homeland, to delight in its everlasting joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated for the reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is full of immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Please stand for the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. He continued, All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Only God is eternal and unchangeable. We humans are subject to change, and so we are subject to time. Ancient philosophers tell us that time is the measurements of change. And we know that a big change has occurred in the life of our sister Emma when she passed from this earth to eternity. When we think about time, we think about the three dimensions of time, the past, the present, and the future. Every time we celebrate a funeral and we think about time and eternity, we cannot be but think about those three dimensions of time. We think about the past. We have the picture of Emma with us, and we think about her life here in Vancouver, that she was a hardworking woman who studied, who worked, who served, who loved her family. And so for all these blessings, we give thanks to God. But also we thank God for the spiritual blessings, the blessing of faith, that last night when we welcomed her body into the church, we sprinkled holy water, put the white paw on the casket, is a good reminder for us of baptism, that we are welcome into the church because of baptism, with holy water, but also at baptism we put on the white garment, symbolizing that we put on Christ, symbolizing the innocence that bring about because of the forgiveness of sin. And then today, at the end of the Mass, we're going to show signs of respect to the body. Once again, using holy water, but also using incense. Incense is a sign of respect. And so we are showing respect to the body because a person who had been baptized became the living temple of the Blessed Trinity, the living temple of the Holy Spirit. And also the body of the faithful being nurtured by the body and blood of Jesus. And so we show respect to the body by using holy water and incense. And of course, incense is also a symbol that the smoke going up, that our prayer rises up to heaven, but also it's a symbol that we are wishing the soul also rise up to heaven, and also the good deeds of the deceased person also able to rise up to heaven as a pleasing offering to Almighty God. And so for the gift of faith, we give thanks to God. And also I was told that Emma was quite Catholic to the end, that, you know, her main concern was because she had been not able to come to church at the nursing home. She was, because of her old age, you know, not able to come out, that she was a concern, you know, haven't been around in the church for a long time. Can I still got a Catholic burial? And of course, you know, her wish being fulfilled today, that, yeah, that of course, she's a member of the church. Once you are baptized, you are forever baptized. So it's a wonderful reality that she longed for this Catholic Mass for her burial, that we pray for her, that we entrust her soul to Almighty God. And we are in the present moment that we are confronted with the reality of death. Death is a separation of the soul and the body. And when we are confronted with a sad reality like death, you know, oftentimes we don't know what to say. And that's okay. You know, we show our love simply by our presence and by our prayer. So today with our presence and prayer, we show our love for Emma, we show our love for her family, and Holy Mother Church, also by her presence and prayer, offer up the greatest of her prayers, the holy sacrifice of the Mass, for the eternal repose of Emma, and also for the comfort of her loved ones. Some people mention that the body of a deceased person preached more eloquently than any preacher on earth, because the body of a deceased loved one reminds us powerfully that we are all on a journey. We are all on a pilgrimage. Think about that. You know, 100 years ago, we were not here. I know tomorrow is Emma's 99th birthday. But for us, 100 years ago, we were not here. And then 100 years later, we won't be here anymore. Today, we say goodbye to Emma. One day will be our turn. We are all on a journey. And so that's why we must look forward to the third dimension of time, the future. Because we are not created for this earth. This earth cannot satisfy us. We are created for God. Only He can satisfy us. Here on earth, yes, we can have true happiness in the extent that we truly love. But here on earth, we do not have perfect happiness. On the one hand, a lot of times we have desire that cannot be fulfilled, and we experience sadness. On the other hand, a lot of time we got what we wanted, and then we get bored, we get tired easily. On the one hand, that is sadness. On the other hand, we get tired and bored. There's no perfect happiness here on earth. But now think about a soul in heaven. A soul in heaven always desires, at the same time, always satisfied. This is the perfect happiness we all desire at the core of our being, because we are created for God. We are created for love, for communion. And so this is the desire that the faithful departed are experiencing. And so today we join our desire with the faithful departed and long for heaven. But also our faith tells us that death doesn't have the last word. Jesus has the last word, because Jesus conquered death by rising from the dead. He died on the cross, shedding his blood, overcoming sin for us. He rose from the dead on Easter Sunday, overcoming death for us for good. And so on the last day, God will raise up our bodies. The God who created us out of nothing, for him is easy to raise up ashes and bones and transform it into a glorified body, like the risen body of Jesus. And so we put the Easter candle prepared on Easter Vigil, is the symbol of the risen body of Jesus. And also we think about, you know, the body of the deceased, the head is over there. Imagine the body getting up. The first thing to see is the Easter candle. So it's a symbol of hope that now, you know, the deceased sleeping the sleep of death, on the last day we will all rise up and we see Christ, the risen Christ, coming in glory. And so if we pay attention to the prayer of the Mass at the funeral, oftentimes we mention that hope of the resurrection. Today, July 16, is the feast of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Oftentimes in religious art, you know, Our Lady of Mount Carmel is linked to the faithful departed, the souls in purgatory, the Our Lady helping the souls to make to heaven. So today, on her feast day, we offer this funeral mass for Emma. We also ask our Blessed Mother to pray for her, to lead her soul to heaven. Today, we recall the past. We thank God for Emma, for all the blessings that God bestowed on her. We are in the present moment, yes, confronted by the sad reality of death, but take comfort of the presence and prayer of Holy Mother Church and of each one of us here. With hope, we look forward to the future, looking forward to the perfect and eternal happiness in heaven, but also looking forward of the blessed hope of the resurrection. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Emma received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Our sister Emma was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Emma seek comfort and consolation. heal their pain, and dispel the darkness and doubt that can come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Emma. Strengthen our hope so that they may live in expectation of your son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
Then pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice
at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the walls of the church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Emma, we beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John the Apostle, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Emma, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and stand. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We now come to the part of Holy Communion. A reminder that Holy Communion is only for practicing Catholics who are sacramentally prepared. So if you are Catholics who practice the faith and are properly prepared, that means have fast an hour beforehand and also with no mortal sin in the soul, you know, if there's mortal sin confession done before the communion, then you are welcome, invited to come for communion. But if you are not ready, you know, or not as a Catholic, then if you want to receive a blessing, you can still come forward. Indicate by putting your right hand on the left shoulder so that I know that not to give you communion, but to pray a blessing for you when you come forward.
I am the bread of life.
Please stand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacraments of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Emma may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. In baptism, Emma shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May she be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our sister Emma, we let this incense rise to God, who has called her to share in his glory. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Emma in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Emma in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servants and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Amen. Dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace and in the sure hope of the resurrection, we take leave of our sister, hoping that one day we shall be with her in heaven.
Table, so if you want to take out the position up to you.